Howdy everybody, ArgonMatrix here, welcome to episode 43 of The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. I think we're just going to do an Isaac run today. Still got a lot to unlock on him, and I just kind of need to get my sea legs underneath me if I'm being honest. G0FB40FG. FJ even. My G's and my J's, I rarely get those confused. I was going to say I always get them confused, but that would just be like an outright lie. Like I just told you, I don't ever get them confused, so I don't know why you would ever think that. And again, my cat is here to welcome us to the day. Hi there, Minu, how you doing? Welcome to the show today. It's been a long flight out here, I know. You had to walk across the windowsill to get here from the bed. It's quite a ways, and I'm sure your paws are tired. What do you have to say? I thought so. Sorry, I wasn't even looking at the screen, I was looking at her so I was probably stopped moving there for a second, but that's okay. This has gotten a little weird, so I'm just gonna... I mean, is it really weird to be talking to your pets? I personally believe that even though, like, to an outsider listening in, talking to your pets sounds like the weirdest shit of all time. I think not talking to your pets is way weirder. That is, like, a sign of something, I don't know. It makes me worry a little bit for the pets, if I'm being honest, but I'm sure for the most part it's fine. I know not everyone is gonna be one of those baby... talking pet gurus. Baby bottle pop. Do those things even still exist out there? I don't remember the last time I've seen them. Granted, I also don't remember the last time I was ever in a proper candy store, which is where I imagine they would sell that type of thing. They wouldn't just be hanging out at the gas station. I will definitely take Tech X. That is a huge, huge first floor get. They should make getting to the Hush fight a little bit easier, if nothing else. So I do still need to do Hush as Isaac. Boss rush is all taken care of, I'm pretty sure. By the way, I know I left those two spirit hearts behind. I will be going back for them. Don't you worry about that. Hopefully I don't just like die to Monstro here. Monstro in a small room is actually pretty rough, as we've seen in the past. I don't think he's ever like outright killed me, but certainly did more damage than I would have liked. I think I'll be able to get up to the back up to my HP cap, though, so no harm, no foul, I would say. Didn't screw up my deal with the devil or anything. Gonna grab these so that I don't screw it up on the next floor, either. Yeah, Tech X is definitely not an instant win right on its own, but it is a huge step up on the competition. Telepills, alright. Well, at least we know which one that is. It's the pure white pills, telepills. It's always a good one to know. Bombs are key, amnesia... class act of pills, honestly. I was excited to have three keys going down to the second floor. I gotta open up my fair supply of treasure rooms. But no such luck, apparently. AWAS, let's just use that. I actually should have saved that. That was not smart on my part. I should have saved that for the potential to skip out a boss rush. But that's okay. Actually, Curse of the Maze helped us out quite a bit there. Let us get into the... treasure room here without needing a key. That can work out nicely sometimes. Mom's Razor is okay at best. It is at least a contributing factor to the Mom transformation, I believe. I don't see why it wouldn't be. Oh man, I just like had dinner and there's like squash stuck in my teeth. I know that's the kind of nasty thing to hear. I probably shouldn't be talking about that, but man. It's just a good reminder that I should probably... Oh, good lord. Well, there goes my deal with the devil chance, probably. That was pretty bad on my part. I just got a little cocky. That's okay. I was gonna say, it's a good reminder that I should probably brush my teeth before recording videos. It's something that I've personally undervalued a lot, is the act of brushing my teeth. I have pretty terrible teeth. For the most part, my health is, like, really good. I'm fairly well-blessed with good genes. But my teeth, I've just, like, taken such bad care of, and I'm not proud of it, honestly. It's a pretty bad thing. I really should have been listening to these dentists all the time. I don't know, I just feel like it's always so inconvenient to take time out of my day to go and brush my teeth. I did get a deal with the devil, actually, here, so... happy with that. But no, if you're like me and you don't brush your teeth very often, or very rarely, don't do that, man. It's bad. I've had to have a root canal in my life. It's not a pleasant time for my mouth or for my wallet. And especially now that I do so many videos, like I do a single Isaac video a day in conjunction with the other series that I'm doing right now, that fishtail, I still don't really know exactly what it does. If it's anything like fish head, it should be okay. But yeah, now since I do that and I'm using my mouth like for several hours a day, every day basically, it's a good thing to probably try and take care of that. Otherwise, I'll end up with a situation like this where I'm like, I got weird stuff in my teeth. My teeth feel all fuzzy. You know that bad feeling? When you just like, when it gets to that point when the teeth feel fuzzy, that's when I'm like, oh man, I really ought to go brush my teeth. Proper dental hygiene is exceedingly important. Extremely and exceedingly important. Did get a key there, so we'll be able to access our item room on this floor. I'm very happy with that. TechX is going to carry us for a while here, but health down is pretty bad. It's like I had to pay for a deal with the devil on the last floor and got like nothing out of it. That's basically what that is. But yeah, TechX will carry us for a decent while here, but if I don't get any sort of damage upgrades or anything, I could be in a bit of a bad spot here. As long as they keep me alive with like spirit hearts and stuff, that's fine too, but there does come a breaking point in Isaac where if you don't have the right amount of damage to deal with the bosses and enemies that you're coming up against, you're not going to have too much fun, is all I can say. Every room taking like a full minute at the very least. Baltar is fine. Don't think that's going to impact my Tech X shots at all, unfortunately. I never know how to value Tech X, like, I know how to value Tech X as the item itself, it's very, very good. But the Tech X shots in particular, I don't know if, like, going big is the best option, or firing smaller, more concentrated bursts is the way to go, because I think the way it works is that only the outer ring of Tech X actually does damage. So in theory, having a smaller concentrated section will do way, way more, right? I don't fully know. I don't know if it's just like the act of touching the circle at all that damages the enemy, or if like it matters how much contact they have with the circle. Regardless, Bighorn being such a huge target is really good for our Tech X purposes. We got an angel room here, which contains prayer card, gives us an eternal card every charge, or an eternal heart. I am totally down with that. Oh, she's back. She's back and ready to join the show for real this time. How you doing there, Manu? I know, yeah. I wish I could hold on. Do you want me to open the window? She likes having the window open so that I can, so that she can, like, look out on the world. But when I open the window, it makes it much more likely that traffic and stuff is gonna get caught up in the background noise. But you know what? For you, Manu, I think I can make an exception today. Here we go. Let some fresh air in here. Oh yeah, she's loving it. She just sticks her face like right up there every time that opens. So pardon every little noise that you might hear in the background of like cars going by or if a train happens to roll by at the wrong moment. If you do hear that, blame the cat, man. And if you complain about it, well, you know, I guess you're just not a cat person then, are you? Put that in your pipe and smoke it. So I don't know how I feel about getting a deal with the angel last floor. I mean, we got a pretty good item out of it. Pretty good defensive item, anyway. It's an item that's interesting, that funnily enough, for having gotten out of a deal with the angel, will help facilitate deals with the devil quite a bit. Because it should give us a ton of HP in the long run. A little brimstone is actually really big, especially because we're already charging our shots as is, so that is a very nice coup. There we go. Not going to open that. I don't think it's probably worth it. Actually, you know, it's worth half a spirit heart. Yeah, I would say there was a luck upgrade in there. That's, I don't know. That's a tough call. At the very least, it's not going to be a game-changing decision. Yeah, so this, if I can get, actually, I'm not sure. I think we found out earlier that Tech X does not really synergize that well with Shielded Tears. Because I was going to say, if we get Shielded Tears, the Hush fight is going to be a breeze. and the Delirium fight if we want to go that way. This is a very powerful run, or the start of a very powerful run anyway. So I could foresee a Delirium in our potential future. I just got a key there for some reason. I'm trying to fathom why. Fishtail somehow? I don't know. I don't have like fanny pack or anything, so who knows, man. Got Binky out of that, that's fine. Let's move on down. Where did that key come from? Did I kill like a little champion that I just didn't see and it dropped a key? That could be, I suppose. I don't mean to rhyme all these things, by the way. I'm a poet and I didn't know it. Yeah, the prayer card is actually extremely good because like you can do a strategy that I was doing for quite a while where you like charge up the prayer card and then just save it for the very end of the floor so you're guaranteed to get an HP upgrade out of it. Oh god, I didn't even see that guy there. He blended right the hell in. I don't think that's honestly the best way to go about it. I think you should just use it at every available opportunity, if I'm honest. And if you get a battery charge on the ground, that is effectively an HP upgrade, so take advantage of that. You have to be a little bit smarter about it. You can't just like pick up the battery and use it every single time, but it is a thing. It is a, it's a very easy strategy to perfect, I would say. It's not a super easy one to mess up. I'm going to take on the first boss here. This is a labyrinth floor, so gonna have to fight Brownie and Mom on this floor and win. At least I hope we win. That'd be a pretty anticlimactic if we just died on the depths too, wouldn't it? Or the depths XL, I suppose. It does look, by the way, like Tech X does synergize with Ball of Tar. There's the Mom transformation. The Yes Mother transformation, if you want to be super technical about it. Which is about the only value that we actually got out of Mom's heals there, because obviously Tech Hex does not benefit from range upgrades. At least I'm pretty sure it doesn't. I don't see how it would. It's like one of those weird floors. It's like an XL floor, but it doesn't feel like an XL floor, you know? Like the way the rooms are laid out. I suppose maybe when we get down into this side of the map, it'll start to get a little more dense. Use that. Almost forgot to use the prayer card. Like I said, every available opportunity, you'll manage to get a lot more HP upgrades out of it than you otherwise might if you just saved it. Yeah, so I don't know. I might take this one down to the void floor, just because I think I'm gonna start operating under the general philosophy that if a run is strong enough to make it to and defeat Hush, then I should just take it down to the void and try to go for the Delirium kill as well, because if it's at that point, it's generally a pretty strong run. Not all the time, but generally. And you're going to need a pretty strong run in order to take down Delirium. So I should like take advantage of that when I get the chance, and I can always go for the actual Isaac kills to progress later into the game, later on, I suppose. I'm going to take Judgment, I guess. It's not like it's a Sophie's choice there. It's just a minor thing, but there we go. I can always use that blood bank to get better pit plays out of Judgment if I really need to, provided it's not like a Demon Judgment or something. Right now I'm trying to save my money for the shop though. This will be the last shop of the game, so hopefully it's not greed. It'll be like our first and last shop of the game because I haven't gone to any of the other ones, I'm pretty sure. See, now I'm in a bit of a conundrum because I was leaning towards saying that like the shorter charges on Tech X were actually the way to go, but I have to charge it up for longer if I want Little Brimstone to activate, so now I'm in a bit of a dilemma. So it's like, what's more valuable to me right now? Is it Tech X or Little Brimstone? And honestly, they're both extremely good. So whenever I can get them both to play off one another, it's fine. I think on a room like this, like a big Tech X ring is totally acceptable to try and hit all enemies at roughly the same times. I got one more round here. Yeah, there he is. There she is. There it is. It's a hand. How can it be anything but an it? I'm going to go ahead and head back this way. A little bit min-maxy on this play. I just don't want to take on a big room when I only have one room needed to charge the prayer card. Here we go, another HP upgrade. See, we've gotten two out of this floor, and we have probably the potential to get a third one, depending on how many rooms are left. I don't anticipate there being like 12 rooms worth of charges left in order to make that happen. I just think that we'll get enough to make a single charge happen, and then we can just take it down to the next floor and get the HP upgrade that way. Yeah, so maybe who knows? I mean, unless we get presented with a really good deal with the devil, maybe we'll just go full red heart build on this run. I wouldn't be too opposed to that. We got two of the same pill there. What could it be? It is explosive diarrhea, huh? Eh, not the greatest in the world, but not the worst. And this one is luck up. Okay, that's good too. Our luck is at a pretty good standing now, I think. Probably at like luck stat at 2. I think a luck stat of like 0 is generally the average, so we're sitting pretty, I suppose. Keep judgment with us. And it may seem like I'm wasting a lot of time on this floor. It's like, oh, look at that timer ticking down. He's not going to make boss rush, but keep in mind I don't want to necessarily make boss rush on this run. If I can somehow, if I get like a teleport card or telepills or something and I can make that work, I'll be very happy to do so. But I don't need to focus on that. It doesn't need to be a laser focus of mine. All right, first treasure room. It's going to be the black bean, Tudon Touch. It's better than the regular bean because it's not an active item, so we at least get some value out of it. Although, if I'm being perfectly honest, it's like, can you give me a little more? I came like way out here into the boonies of this run to pick that up. I was expecting a little bit higher value out of that. I think that was actually a pretty clutch dodge at the end there. Oh, it is greed, damn it. That's okay. At the very least, we'll still have the blue womb shop if we can get there in time, which I think we should definitely be able to get there in time. This could be actually a really good run for donation power now that I'm looking at it, depending on how much this judgment wants to take. I was waiting to use them until I saw what the shop had to offer, so. Make hay while the sun shines now. The compass is actually pretty stellar. So we got our one item room left down there, a self-sacrifice room if we're interested in that. I don't think I am on this run. Taking the long way around. It's not for any really good reason, I just didn't want to fight those other two rooms. Probably would have taken about the same amount of time, if not less, so... It's okay. The lovers could be good later on. We don't have a huge stockpile of spirit hearts or anything, but we do have a huge stockpile of red hearts. Right, double chub, I think. I always tried to like finagle it and like get chub to go onto the spikes in this room. It's kind of hard, like their AI is pretty good about not wanting to charge straight onto those spikes. See, yeah, he stopped like right before he's about to hit him there. If you can get him on the spikes, and I have before, I'm pretty sure, then they just outright destroy him. He's just such a big target that he takes so much damage from it. But generally not a strategy you can typically rely on. My god! They're all... Please, no touch. No touch. Bad touch. Telepathy for dummies is pretty bad. I'll pick it up for the bookworm transformation potential. And I guess we'll move on to the mom fight, if nothing else tickles our fancy here. Not gonna have any potential to warp out a boss rush, it seems like, so... I mean, I could bomb these skulls and try to get a teleport card that way, but you know, let's just go, man. We don't need to go for too many advantages here. If it is like a game-changing sort of item up in boss rush, I might fight the whole thing to try and do it. Emphasis on the might, though. It's not a priority of mine by any means, especially because that might compromise my ability to get down to hush in time, and that would be bad. I mean, I'd still be able to make like an Isaac run work, I suppose. It would still be a win in theory. I mean, in practice, I hope it'll be a win as well, but. Man, she's just taking it today. Mom's kind of lax. There we go. Oh, I thought that was gonna be it. There it is. We got another angel room here. Pick up the negative, of course. And what is in here? We got Circle of Protection. I unlocked a forgotten horseman in the basement. We got Conquest now. I didn't even realize he had to be unlocked, I guess. I guess that's for picking up a certain amount of angel items. I mean, I could pick up... I mean, Host Hat is good. Makes me immune to explosions. I don't think it's good enough. I could make a funny play, pick up the Glowing Hourglass, warp out of Boss Rush, and I don't know if I'd still have the Glowing Hourglass. I think I probably wouldn't, based on how that item works, but I'm not going to chance it. It's nothing too crazy to worry about. Alright, get an HP upgrade here. We got Curse of the Blind, which is kind of shitty. Got a dice room down there. I owe it to myself and to the viewers to try and see what that could have in store for us. If it's like a one room or a six room, hey, I could have some fun with that. We'll have plenty of other Tech X runs throughout the course of our Isaac life here, I'm sure, so what's a little bit of a chance on that reroll? Might it screw up the hush fight chances? Almost certainly, but you gotta live zany sometimes, right? You gotta live a little bit on the edge. What's the point in playing a video game if you're not gonna have fun, if you're just gonna be perfect all the time? I mean, for some people, that's totally reasonable. For some people, being perfect in a video game is the fun part. I consider myself in that minority on occasion. Might even be a majority, not a minority. But in this specific case, I mean, we're basing it on the assumption that this dice room down here is going to be a full run reroll. And it could be, it's like not even likely to be. Like the odds of it are lower than it being anything else, so let's see. I mean, there are two different ones that can give it to you, so let's just see here. It is a one room, which is a reroll, so I guess I have to put my money where my mouth is now, don't I? Well, shit. Alright, I'm gonna do two more rooms to get a charge on the prayer card, just so I can get a little more value out of it here before I have to say goodbye, and then we'll do that. Ooh, we got a secret room out of that. We're not gonna have the compass after this reroll either, so that's something to keep in mind. I guess I'll keep temperance. Probably the best out of those options. Okay. This room should be easy enough. As long as I don't take two hits of damage on this room, I'll be fine to keep that Eternal Heart in check. There we go, and use that. Last HP upgrade out of a prayer card, so thank you, my good friend. You were a great service person. Time to say goodbye. I will keep the lovers, I think. What do we got here? I got anti-grav tears. I've got like $3 bill or like something. I've got tough love. I don't think I have $3 bill. I have like charm shots. Very good tier rate, if I'm being honest. Let me check my my actual damage stat. 3.52. That's like base damage for Isaac, which is not great. But I mean, our damage on the other one wasn't much better. But we also did have Tech X, so yeah, I don't know about this one. This seems bad. This seems pretty fucking bad. But I don't know. We'll try and make it work here. I mean, we don't have much of a choice now, do we? We do have Daddy Long Legs. Hey, that's nice. And it seems to be doing a decent amount. I'm scared to see. We also have, like, Creep Shot, by the way. We have, like, the pimple there. Maybe, like, Egg Sack Tears, too? I don't know. We have the Egg Sack, like, the Bursting Sack, so spiders won't hurt us. Yeah, I don't know how this is going to fare on the Hush fight. It seems like kind of a nightmare for that fight. Can I fly? I thought I could fly there for a second. I was like, whoa, this is a new world, man. A whole new world. Full of anti-gravitational tears. Hell, I might not even make the Hush fight now that I'm, I mean, I still have 9 minutes to make it. I know where the boss is. I won't know where the boss is on the next floor. Keep that in mind. Which way do I go? Oh, there's a room down there that faces right towards the boss. I should have gone straight for that, probably. It's okay. I'm gonna keep this lover's card. I could use it right now and just, like, get some value out of it. No point in it when there's a heart right there, though. I should probably save the lover's card for the Hush fight in particular, or for just a dicey room that I encounter before then, if worst comes to worst. What we got in here? This might be worth it. Doesn't seem to have been. Temperance card is not what I'm looking for today. Do I want second hand to double, or to extend at least the duration of my stat effects? I think, honestly, I don't know what Fishtail is really doing for me. So we're going to try out second hand here for extended charm time and potential extended slow time as well. I don't know if it works necessarily with that. And I don't know how extended it is, if it's like double the duration on those stat effects, or if it's like something else. Just like, if it's just like 50% upgrade, a 30% upgrade, who knows. Trinkets generally aren't that clear cut. I mean, they are from a mechanics standpoint, but they don't tell you. But I'm gonna turn Found HUD off, by the way. Hardly even noticed it there. Maybe that's a sign that I should just leave it on all the time, but I'm doing fine with it without it for now. Yeah, but honestly, for what it equates to base damage, this is honestly not that bad of a run. It looked a lot worse on just the offset than it does in practice here. IV bag is not really something that I'm interested in. Sister's V's. If they want to jump on that, then, aw, oh man, they didn't jump on my cluster. That's okay. Yeah, if I can read them just right and see where they're about to jump, I can maybe cluster some shots beneath them. Or I can just, like, you know, kill them. That's also an option, I suppose. Yeah, this tier raid is actually just, like, killing it right now. That is the main thing, I think, that is saving this run. Got the Screw, which is a Tears and Shot Speed upgrade. Probably not going to make a huge difference. Guardian Angel is totally fine. I'm going to try to bomb some of these for Spirit Heart purposes. Also got homing bombs, I've noticed there. I think that's what that is. Like the little, like, kind of clock winder on the bombs. So that is usually indicative of that. Alright. I do not still have the compass. In fact, I didn't think I would. I was, like, kind of hopeful that maybe I would for some reason, but nah. It's okay. I should have waited, to be fair, to try and go for that Tinted Rock. Because obviously the homing bombs are going to get pulled away. It's okay. It's alright. You know what? Just bomb through this room. If we can. I was going to say, it might just get pulled away by the homing factor. Why did I try to bomb through that room, by the way? I'm just getting a little nervous about the hush fight potential. It seemed like I was going to be a dead ringer for that fight early on in this run, but things have definitely taken a bit of a turn here. I think I will try and just clear out this room, because if another one of those is a dead end, then I'll be a big old waste of bombs. These guys are easy enough because they chase me down, so... I mean, generally they chase me down. Are they being smart about it today? Come on. Oh, good. That guy's not that strong. Come on, I was about to say. More freaking gurglings, huh? I just put one there. I'm fine bombing out of this room. It's just a dead end. Oh, I didn't even need to because Daddy Longlegs finished off the job. Well, poo on me, I guess. Random spirit heart out of the poop there. That's pretty cool. Pretty sure that was random anyway. I don't think I have anything that increases those odds. Except just my base luck stat, I suppose. These spirit hearts, though, maybe I have the miter. That wouldn't be the worst thing in the world, I suppose. It's not the greatest thing, because, I mean, I have 11 red hearts. So my potential to carry spirit hearts is not that great. But it is there, I suppose. Alright, are you gonna... These guys are fairly straightforward with anti-grav tiers here. As you can see, I'm sure. Just kinda have to bait them. I mean, you don't even have to bait them, you just have to put it literally in their path and they'll kill themselves for you. Easy as that. Honestly, these tough love shots, the tooth shots, they are pretty huge as well. I think I'll keep the lovers. Oh, that full health pill, that would have been so good to know about. That's okay. Hopefully we can find another one, maybe on the Hush Shop, who knows. That would be huge, because my big play right now is to try and save this Lover's card for the Hush fight, and see if I can make that work. That was dumb, but it's okay. Alright, We have plenty of bombs. Don't need to worry about wasting them too much here. Okay. So against my worries, it looks like we'll still have be able to make the Hush fight here with plenty of time to spare. Right, this isn't the worst it lives fight of my natural born life. It's going all right so far. Honestly, also these creep shots, the slowing ones, they're like pretty handy here too. That combined with second effect, we have a lot of things contributing towards this run being good, trying to make up for its sort of lackluster damage here. And good stuff. No devil deal or anything. Only four keys, but we're gonna head down to the blue moon regardless. Gotta get this Hush kill at some point or another. Whether this is gonna be powerful enough to do it, I'm not sure. Not sure either if I want to take on the void anymore. Money equals power. Ooh, that's really good. But it does sort of make me. Oh my god! How does monstros? How does? I mean, I think I have to go with Deadeye. I don't know how Monstrous Lung would work with this. I feel like it would make it worse somehow. That's just what my gut feeling tells me. I don't really need Humbling Bundle. Actually, Humbling Bundle is probably a smart idea. Oh, the problem is I don't want to spend too much money. But Humbling Bundle will make each of the hearts I get from the lovers a double heart. Fuck it, man. I managed to make it out to this far without the bonus for money equals power. I can make it further. I'm gonna donate up to probably down to 20 cents here. I still want a little bonus out of money equals power as much as I can get here. The Joker, this could be huge. We got Dark Bomb and Guppy's Hairball. I mean, I don't think I want either of them. They're both good in their own right. Like, one's a Guppy item, one is a Dark Bomb. This would be good if we had any other Guppy items, but we don't. And this would be good if we had a Stockhold of Spirit Hearts, but we don't. So, that's gonna be that, I guess. I will buy this, just to see if I can make this work. I might get some more money out of it, if nothing else. Anyway. Honestly, I think a play here is to do this a little bit. IV bag could be pretty nice. Do I think it's smart? Where's my lover's card, by the way? There it is. I was like, oh god, I lost it. Shit, I mean. Alright, you know what? It's fine. And that's enough money to make money equals power at least somewhat worth it. I forget exactly what the conversion rate is on money equals power. I think it's different for every character anyway. For Isaac, it's something like 0.04 damage percent or something? I don't know. That actually seems pretty low, if that is the case. Eh, maybe not, I don't know. Regardless, it looks like that in conjunction with Deadeye here is going to make a pretty nice chunk of difference. This was actually like a major upgrade for us on these blue womb items, so it's gonna make the Hutch fight actually somewhat realistic here. I'm actually gonna just pop the lover's card so that I have those hearts kind of lying around for when I need them. Just don't want to run over them too prematurely, you know, because I could like just lose one hit and then pick up one, and that'd be a bit of a waste. Not the worst thing in the world, I suppose, but. And if it turns out that I don't actually need those red hearts, if like I manage to go through this Hush fight without taking that many hits, I can use IV bag to get value out of those hearts as well, so it's a win-win situation for me. I will at the very least say this run is a lot more interesting than it would have been if I had just stuck with Tech X, Little Brimstone. That would have been a lot more boring to watch, I think. I think the tiers that we have now are way cooler than Tech X, and that takes a lot, honestly. Like, having enough tier effects to make Tech X seem, like, mundane in comparison is a bit of a tall ask, but I think we've kind of made it work here. Normally, anti-grav tiers are a bit of a handicap, honestly. It makes it more difficult to have a winning sort of run, but we've found a combination that works for us here. Would it be better without anti-grav tiers? That's debatable. I mean, we wouldn't have as good of a tier rate without anti-grav tiers, because it is also a tiers up. I always tend to forget that. I don't know. It's tough to say without actually seeing it in practice, but I think anti-grav tiers at least make it more novel, if nothing else. Is he firing continuum shots? It's hard to tell what he's doing. He's way over here. He is firing continuum shots. Careful. I've got some orbitals doing some good job in terms of the blocking. That's good. And I think I will try and take this down to the void. I think it has the potential to work. If it works against Hush, then it's already one step towards beating Delirium, as far as I'm concerned. I would say Delirium is definitely harder than the Hush. But they're not so separated in terms of their difficulty that it's gonna mean like I can easily beat one and then die to the other or something. Although, is this considered easily beating the Hush? That's up for debate as well, I suppose. Oh god. I have like this tiny little hitbox, so it's hard for me to tell. Like, I keep thinking that I'm big fan. I keep thinking that that's my like main hitbox. Clearly it's not, but the slowing effect is actually working wonders as well in this fight. A little bit like having a whatever, I'm drowsy pill. That's the one. It's almost like having that. We have that much slowdown power. It's kind of crazy. Alright, he's almost there. Hopefully he doesn't go down anymore. That's probably wishful thinking on my part, but there we go. Okay, we got it cleared out. And enough to spare a fart baby has appeared in the basement. That's what I fucking get for that? That's a waste. Oh well. Just want to make sure I'm not missing out on anything too valuable down here. Tinted rock or something. I could like buy a spirit heart in the shop, I'm pretty sure. But I don't think that's worth the value that I get out of 5 cents worth of damage in Money Equals Power. There's something weird going on with this void portal. It's like weird and static. I'm gonna go in and hope for the best. Hopefully it doesn't just like kill me. It was moving for a second there. It like moves when I'm on top of it, but not at any other time. Can I not get in there for some reason? All right. And go. Send me down to the void. I want to kill Delirium. What is this garbage? Is it really not going to let me go? Is this void portal just that bugged? I've had them bugged before, but not quite like this. Not in such a... Like, the game did update before I started this recording. I looked at the update notes and it didn't seem like anything too crazy, but maybe it broke this? I really hope not. Well, I don't want to waste too much more of your guys' time, so I guess we're just going to go and try and take on Isaac instead. It'll still be a completion note, I suppose, but I was kind of looking forward to the void. I don't know. Oh lord, what is this room? Like the Great Hall of King Boo or something. Oh well, that's a bit of a bummer in all honesty, because I think this had the potential to kill Delirium, but at the same time, it's still a fun run. We're still gonna make the cathedral our bitch here, and it'll put us one step closer to unlocking that second puzzle on our save file screen, the other one that's overlaid on top of the negative. Which is always good. I am always a fan of progress in any sense of the word. And I'm sure we'll have plenty of other opportunities to take down Delirium. Hopefully that was just a one-time occurrence and not like a thing that's actually like bugged for now. I guess we'll find out next time we try to do that. I was hoping for maybe some money out of one of these, but it's probably not worth the time investment. my damage is good enough as it is, so. But just imagine how good it would be if I had 99 cents, man. That would be so... Ooh. I just tingle thinking about the size that those tiers could be. Oh boy. That's pretty good. Yeah, Humbling Bundle was definitely the right call on that hush fight. Yeah, see, these portals, the ones that are like enemies that spawn things, they're not static, they're looking just fine. So it's just the teleport portal down to Delirium that is kind of freaking out. And granted, before the update, it was still like kind of freaky and janky. It wasn't working quite as intended, I don't think, because I had to like step on it multiple times in order to make it work most of the time. But eventually I would always get down to the void after like maybe two or three attempts at it. That time I was just like, I felt like it was just running over nothing basically. Maybe this, you know, would be the worst of all worlds, is it, maybe that's just something that can happen sometimes. Maybe it's just like doesn't let you go to the void sometimes, because it's just a void. It's like a bugged sort of dimension. Like, that's just in the lore. Who knows? That doesn't seem likely. It doesn't seem like they would bar you entry. By the way, triple monstro on this room can go fuck itself, as far as I'm concerned. And a trap door down to Sheol? I'm not playing with fate there. I don't want to go down to Sheol. Not on this run. I already got screwed out by the void portal. I'm not about to play with fire and mess up my Isaac wind as well. Should probably go back for that spirit heart back there, but I still have plenty of health to fall back on, so I'm not super concerned or anything. Alrighty. Got Guppy's head out of the last chest here. That's actually pretty nice. Finish off Isaac, call it a day. We'll be good to go. I mean, who knows? If maybe the void portal will appear after Isaac here, we'll be able to get the best of both worlds, provided that the void portal actually works on this floor. Let's see, I suppose. If not, there's always next time. Ooh. All I know is that after this episode, I'm going to submitting a bug report. Tyrone! He's got enough on his plate without my ass worrying him down. Alright. No void portal, so we'll just take our win and bounce out of here. Isaac's tears have appeared in the basement. Oh, we unlocked 2 A+ items on this run. Isaac's tears and fart baby. Sounds great. I got another piece of that, though, so it looks like maybe 2, maybe 3 more pieces, and we'll be able to complete that. That'll be it for today, though, so thank you everyone for watching. Hope you enjoyed this run, despite the sort of anti-climax towards the end there. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like and or comment down below the video, letting me know as such. It helps keep me motivated to make more of these every single day. I post one at noon Mountain Time, so if you want to stay notified of that, subscribe. You will see it in your subscription feed, provided YouTube is working on any given day. It's a 50-50 shot, you know. At any rate, thanks everyone for watching. This is ArgonMatrix, signing out. Thank you and good night.